How did you begin your career as a musician?
Well, I would say my career started out pretty early. I was a product of a household of musicians. My mother played the piano, and my brother played the piano, and my father played the trombone. Mm-hmm. So I immediately got thrown into music at church, at a Baptist church, and I used to go up behind the drummer after the church and just kind of be, you know, ask him, could I play? So he would let me get on and I would play. He'd like, okay. He's like, I'm gonna show you something. And then he would take one hand and play all this stuff. Mm-hmm. And then I would go home and be like, okay, I want to do that. You know what I mean? And that's how it started, man. Then I started playing a little bit at church. Then I went on to middle school and I was in the marching band. Mm-hmm. And then from there, I went to a performing arts high school, which so many great artists have gone to now that you see out playing jazz and pop, other stuff. Mm-hmm. And then I went on to Berklee College of Music.
Yeah.
And here I am today.
Yeah. I know you worked on a lot of soundtracks, didn't you?
Yes.
Which ones did you work on exactly?
Whoa. It's been a few. We did, with Terrence, we worked on Their Eyes Are Watching God, which was produced by Oprah Winfrey, and Halle Berry was in that one. We worked on Inside Man by Spike Lee, She Hate Me by Spike Lee. I've done some stuff on Waist Deep. Von D. Curtis was the director. I can't even remember.
So many. All of,
it's not so many, but I mean, it's probably about 9 or 10, mm-hmm. maybe. Mm-hmm. But it's been an honor for me to do those because I get into a whole nother field that I'm not readily used to all the time. And mm-hmm. Being around Terrence has been great because he's been encouraging in every way, but mostly in the way of writing. And for mm-hmm. a drummer, that's kind of a stretch, you know what I mean, mm-hmm. for us. So he constantly has me writing for things and everything. Mm-hmm. And through him kind of working with me, trying to get me into the film world, mm-hmm. that's also how I came to write on some of his CDs. When he was getting into the business and working with Spike, you know, he had an opportunity to do something, and Spike asked him to write for an orchestra, and it was his first time, so he said, yes, I'll do it, and he got thrown into the fire,
yeah.
and look at where he is today, yeah. you know, 40 or 50 films later.
He didn't get burned.
No, he didn't get burned, so... You know, it's encouraging to me just to know that he has that confidence in me,
yeah.
to give me these tasks and also to play on stuff and to write for stuff. So it's yeah. it's great. It's a great feeling.
Sure, sure.
Yeah. Well, my record. I have a record label called yeah. World Culture Music,
uh-huh.
and my most recent CD is called The Source, and it's been out for a few years. That was my first CD on my record label,
mm-hmm.
but now I have a new CD coming out mm-hmm. on May 18th, and it's on the Crisscross label.
Yeah.
It's a record of standards, mm-hmm. and I've rearranged some of them, some of my favorite composers. Some things that I used to play when I was younger that I came back to and wanted to touch on away from my label. Because what I mostly want to do on my label is focus on composition. And so on my label, I'll do all of my compositions and things. So I wanted to do something for the people who have influenced me. So I named the CD Reverence. And... So I have some tunes by Wayne Shorter on there, some by Kenny Dorham.
Mm-hmm.
I got a tribute to Max Roach on there. It's called Know You, Know Me. Some Ornette Coleman on there.
Oh.
So it's gonna be a nice CD. It's called Reverence. It'll be on Crisscross.
Who else is appearing on the album?
Derek Hodge plays the bass. Walter Smith on the tenor saxophone. Mike Moreno on the guitar, and Gerald Clayton on the piano. So it'll be a good release.
That's good. What made you begin your own label? What were the reasons for that?
Well, I think there are a lot of different reasons. First of all, I wanted to do my own CD, and I felt that as a drummer, I don't know, I felt like I should be a catalyst for something different, for some type of change in the industry, because I saw how pretty much everything was going, you know. And it's kind of going under at this point, you know what I mean? It's weird right now, but I don't think the main draw for music is the record industry. I think it's the music, and that's why I created my own label. Because it's right now, it's so easy to get music to people that you really don't need a record company to do that.
They sold themselves, really.
Yeah,
they've sold enough records. Now it's time to move on. It's got too big for them.
Right, right. So I mean, I still see validity in both ways, but at that time when I was doing my label, I was like, why should I be worried about getting signed? How this and that and that. I was just like, let me put the music out and let the music speak for itself.
Yeah.
So I started my own label, and then I did three other CDs. The way it happened was I did three other CDs of my friends who were also in the same predicament, who wanted to take their CDs and shop them and do all of this stuff. And I'm like, why are we doing all this when we can just put it out ourselves? So in the end, we created World Culture Music, and there it is. So we're trying to do some new CDs very soon within this year. And we're just trying to keep it going because, right now it's a huge idea in our minds to be very close to have the artist be close to the people that he's giving the music to. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I think sometimes in the record industry thing, it gets so far away from that and so far away from the real message, which is to touch people's lives, is not just the marketing side of it and all that stuff. It's more about the music than it is, you know what I mean? So,
over concentration on the marketing and on the business can disrupt the music. I think it very often has. I mean, I'm sure there's so many musicians who had an idea to bring out an album in a certain way, and then they spoke with the boss, and he said, "Well,
yeah,
you know," and then just.
Yeah.
Destroys people, actually.
And it gets misconstrued also because they can put all of that wonderful backing behind something that's not
any good.
Any good too.